Here's a quick search engine optimization tip that your patients will definitely appreciate. My name is Michael Roberts and I work with P3, and I'm going to talk to you today about your online listings. So one of the simple things that practices can do to make sure that they're being found more often in search is to make sure that your online listings, places like Google Maps, Bing Maps, even things like Yelp and other systems that you wouldn't necessarily think of first, all of these things matter because you're looking for a consistency among all of that information. There's a quick little abbreviation, and it's the NAP that you need to pay attention to. So when you're looking at your online listings, are the NAP correct? The name, address, and phone number. Are you seeing consistently that your information is showing up correctly? Now, each of the systems have a little different way of correcting that information, of updating that information, and you'll probably need to go through the process of claiming your listing in order to get this stuff all set up correctly. So what I want to do is show you an example in Google, just of a physician that needs to get some of the NAP information cleaned up in his listing. And we're not picking on him in particular, because we find that a lot of practices, when we start working with them, this isn't something that they pay attention to, but it's something that can really help you improve not only very basic searches for your practice, but also a lot of your overall SEO, your search engine optimization value as a whole. So let's jump into Google and we'll take a look at this. What I'm going to do is take a look for a physician that we identified earlier as we were doing some research here, and it's Dr. Carl Smith in Minneapolis. And like I said, this isn't picking on Dr. Smith at all, but this is something that we see quite a bit. So as you look at this information, you can see that we've got a map listing here, and it's interesting because Google will show this information in a variety of ways depending on what information is available, what information they may find. So right now, the way that I'm seeing it is that Dr. Carl Smith has one location. But if I go to Maps here, I just clicked on the Maps listing there, and you'll find that there's actually two different listings for Dr. Smith, and they're listed in different ways. And that's the information that can get a little confusing, not so much for patients, because as people, we can kind of identify pretty quickly that here's what's happening and here's what's going on. But think of it from a machine learning, trying to understand and match up all this information. So you'll see Smith Carl SMD, and then you'll see Dr. Carl Smith, Carl S. Smith MD. And so this information is set up a little bit differently depending on which way that each location has this information listed out. And this could have arisen from several different factors. This could have happened because of just the way that the information was displayed. It doesn't matter. There's a lot of ways that it can get a little messy in there. So here's something that you can do, is just to get in there and start looking at these listings a little bit more. See if you can claim this listing. You'll see here in this option, you've got the ability to claim this business. Now, Google is protecting the businesses that are listed here, so you can't just claim it if you don't have all the information that you need. You sometimes need to mail a postcard to that address. Do something along those lines to help verify that, yes, I am really this person. This is what I need to do in order to get this listing claimed. But what you want to do not only is look at how you're listed in Google, but also look in Bing Maps, also look at Apple Maps. Look at these systems that you know that patients are using quite a bit. Pay attention to what phones your patients are pulling out as they're talking to you about it, because these are the kinds of searches that they're doing as they're on their way to your practice. So this is just like one of many things that you can do to start working on your search engine optimization, but it's a simple and straight ahead tip that businesses are able to handle on their own. And I would really encourage you, if you haven't looked yet, do this for your own search engine optimization, but do it for your patients and make it easier on them as well. Thank you.